of your questions about God and the Bible.
With me, Bob.
And me, Herb.
We're the Answer Guys. Do you have a question for us today, Herb?
I sure do.
Let's make it an easy one this time.
I can't make any guarantees about that. This question comes from Melissa from Germantown, Ohio.
There are so many people in the world who get sick or get hurt, but they're good people. If God loves us so much, then why do bad things happen to people?
Oh, boy.
What's the matter, Bob?
So much for getting an easy question.
But that's a very good question.
Yeah, but I think it's a bit above my pay grade.
It is a hard question. But there's a story in the Bible that I think will help us understand this a bit better.
Noah and the Ark.
No.
Jonah and the Whale.
No.
The Tortoise and the Hare.
What?
Oh, sorry. That's not even in the Bible.
This is a story about Jesus and a blind man.
Oh, I know this one. Jesus spit on the ground to make some mud, rubbed it in the man's eyes, gross, and then he was able to see.
Yes. But there's more to the story than that. It's found in John chapter 9, and it says that when the disciples saw the man, they asked Jesus if he was blind because he had sinned or because his parents had sinned.
I say it was the parents.
No.
Right. I meant it was the man's fault.
Wrong again.
Say what?
Jesus told them that he wasn't blind because of sin. He was blind so that God's power could be shown in his life.
That's what I meant to say.
Sure you did.
So then Jesus healed him.
This time you're right.
So bad things happen because they are a part of achieving God's purposes.
You've got it.
There you have it, Melissa. Everybody who has a problem gets a miracle to fix it.
That's right. Wait, no. Romans 8:28 tells us that in all things, God works for the good of those who love him.
So even when something seems bad, God is still working for our good.
That's right.
Wouldn't it be easier if God just gave everybody a miracle?
That would be nice, but we don't always see...
But we don't always see what God's plan is. But we know that he's working for our good.
See, Bob, you could have answered that question after all.
I guess it seemed like a bad question, but it really was a good question.
Well, Melissa from Ohio, we hope that answers your question.
Join us next time for more of your questions with...
The Answer Guys!
Oh,
trying through smiles and frowns. Love never says die, even when it gets rough. True love just never gives up. No matter what, Jesus loves you. His love just keeps going on.
And on, and on, and on, and on. When other friends disappoint you,
you can be sure he is there all along. Cause God never gives up, love never lets down. Love keeps on trying through smiles and frowns. Love never says die, even when it gets rough. True love just never gives up.
Love is patient and kind.
Never jealous or envious. Never boastful or proud. Never haughty or selfish or rude. Love does not demand its own way. It is not irritable or touchy. It does not hold grudges and will hardly even notice when others do it wrong.
Love is gentle and patient.
He gives and then gives some more and more and more and more and more.
It shares without hesitation.
And doesn't even try. Smiles and frowns. Love never says die, even when it gets rough. True love just never gives up. Love never gives up. Love never lets down. Love keeps on trying. He smiles and frowns. Love never says die, even when it gets rough. True love just never gives up. True love just never gives up.
You and I get tempted. It happens to everyone. It don't matter how righteous you are. It even happened to God's own son. Well, the devil just wants to drag us down, and there's nothing that he won't try. We need to call on the Lord in the time of temptation, cause the devil is the father of lies, and that's why. They say you don't give temptation a look, you don't skip devotions again, you don't quench the prompting of the Holy Spirit, and you don't mess around with sin. But so if you wonder why when you serve the Lord it seems like you're under attack, it's because you're still at war with God's church and it wants to knock you flat. And everybody knows that. They say you don't give temptation a look, you don't skip devotions again, you don't quench the prompting of the Holy Spirit, and you don't mess around with sin. But so let's claim the victory through Christ our Savior and put our trust in Him, and we'll win. Cause they say you don't give temptation a look, you don't scare.